S&P Productions y Kingdom Coalition Ministerial Alliance. Orgullosamente presenta por primera vez en Lehigh Acres, Florida, una noche de concierto con el Trío de Hoy. Trío de Hoy. Noviembre 6 del 2015 a las 6 de la noche en la Iglesia de Cristo Sendero de Esperanza, que radica en el 507 Sunshine Boulevard, Lehigh Acres, Florida. Para más información y boletos, pueden llamar al Pastor Pete Marrero al 239-240-0483, 239-240-0483, o a Andrés Santos al 239-257-0493, 239-257-0493. No se pierda una noche de concierto con el Trío de Hoy en vivo. Les esperamos. Auspiciado por Kingdom Coalition Ministerial Alliance Incorporated, New Dimension Network Immigration Services, Sonia Rios Realty, SMP Productions, Sendero de Esperanza y Crystal Film Production.
Welcome to the Community Awareness TV Show, being brought to you by Crystal Film Productions in conjunction with Kingdom Coalition Ministerial Alliance. I am your host, Pete Marrero. We have a wonderful show for you here today with a great guest. So hold on. Sit tight, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. You are watching the Community Awareness Show. Welcome back to the Community Awareness TV Show. Today we have a great guest with us on our show, Ms. Kitty Green from Habitat for Humanity. And I'm going to introduce her right now. Ms. Green, thank you for coming on our show today, Community Awareness. I want to start right away by asking you, let our viewers know what is Habitat for Humanity, even though it is a common name, well known. But I want you to introduce yourself, let me know a little bit about you, and then we're going to go right into Habitat for Humanity.
Okay. Well, first of all, Habitat for Humanity is a Christian ministry. And our mission is to put God's love into action by building homes, communities, and hope. Okay. And we bring people together. That's really what we're about, is partnerships. And I personally, I'm currently the CEO of Habitat for Humanity, and I've been that for 5 years. But I was born and raised in Fort Myers, Florida, and had a long career in the private sector. And while I was doing that, I was a volunteer on the board of directors for this Habitat for Humanity. And really believe in the mission and love what we do. And so when the present executive director for Habitat retired, I decided that the right thing for me to do was to come to work for Habitat. So I've been there 5 years and I love it. There's no better job.
Great. Let me know a little bit about your family. You have kids, you have...
Sure. Yes, I'm married 30 some years, long time.
Oh, okay. I'll get you for that.
He has to be around to tell me how many years.
Right, right. So. Okay, that's good.
And I have three grown stepkids, five grandkids, and I have twin girls who are graduating Fort Myers High School this year.
Great. So. Now, you mentioned that you've been with Habitat for Humanity for 5 years, but I want to know what actually drove you to that and your passion being part of Habitat for Humanity.
I love the fact that Habitat for Humanity is about partnering with people. It's not about handing out gifts or bestowing kindness. It's about working with people to help them help themselves. And when you see the families that come to see us, they have a need and they want to find a way to address the need. And when we help give them the tools to address the need, to see them earn their own home, and the pride that they have in having invested themselves in that process and knowing that they can raise their children in their own home, in a stable, affordable home. There's nothing better than that.
Now, how would they go about, on that note, what you just said, providing the tools necessary for them to have their own home? How does that work?
Well, Habitat evaluates families, low-income families. We serve families that make up to 80% of the area median income. So we're essentially helping families that are working low-income families. So the lowest income range might be in the $18,000, $20,000 range, and the highest income range that we could serve would be, say, $46,000 for a family of four. So that's the area that we're looking to help. And if those families, there's only really three selection criteria. One is need. Are you paying too much for where you're living now? And that's pretty much every low-income family in this area is. This is a very expensive housing market.
Right.
I don't know if you follow the news, but recently they announced that the average two-bedroom apartment rental in Lee County is $1,035.
Yes.
There's no way that that a low-income family can pay that. So what we see is families doubled up or tripled up and living in conditions that just aren't conducive to raising healthy, stable children.
Right.
So they come to us and we evaluate their need. We evaluate their ability to pay. This is not a gift. They pay a zero interest mortgage that's based on 30% of their income. Mm. So they have to have some kind of income source. And then we ask them about their willingness to partner with Habitat. And the willingness to partner piece is we require that they put 300 volunteer hours, we call it sweat equity.
Okay.
They put 300 hours into their house or somebody else's house or volunteering with us in some other capacity. They have to save up $1,700 for closing costs. And they have to spend a full weekend with the total of a full weekend with us learning about the responsibilities of home ownership. Because for people who've never owned a home before, you know, things like homestead exemptions and taxes and things like that you just don't know about. So we spend a lot of time teaching them about budgeting, about how do you take care of a home, maintenance, and all sorts of things, because we want them to be really successful once they're a homeowner.
Do they need perfect credit to be with Habitat for Humanity?
There are very few low-income people with perfect credit.
Exactly.
And if they had perfect credit, they probably could go to a bank and get a conventional loan, which is almost impossible to get.
Right.
So no, they don't need perfect credit. What we look for, we don't look at a credit score. What we look for is, do you consistently make your rent payment?
Correct.
Do you pay your water bill and your electric and those necessities? Often we are much more flexible around things like medical expenses. Mm-hmm. Often people have large medical expenses because of things that happen that they're not prepared for. And so we are more flexible than a bank would be, but still we want to see that somebody
is
ready for this step in their lives.
Now, how would they get that information? Do you have a website, a phone number? Can you please let me know?
They can initially contact us. Our main phone number is area code 239-652-0434. And our website has a lot of information on it as well, and that is www.habitatforhumanity.org. So it's Habitat for Humanity. The four is not the word, it's the number four.
Okay.
So, and it's .org at the end.
Great. Where do you see the need as far as the market for... I know there are a lot of low-income families that we have here in Lee County, Hendry County. Where have you seen the need most? In what demographic?
Honestly, we see it across the board. It's very interesting. We have a session, at least one, usually multiple sessions every month, that is the very initial information session that everybody's invited to. And it basically explains to them what our program's about. So the people that come to that are people who have a need and they don't know much else. And when I look around that room, there are black people, white people, brown people, old people, young people.
Okay.
It's amazing. It really is. And we serve everybody regardless of, we are a Christian ministry, but we serve everybody regardless of whatever their race or ethnicity or religious background may be.
No discrimination.
None.
That is great to know, because some people are intimidated. They might think, well, that's not for me because I'm Spanish or I'm black or even if I'm white. And it's good to know that there's an organization here that is willing to serve and see the needs of the people. And that's why we have you here today. I'm so glad that you're with us today. I also, offset, we were talking about that you've seen a large number within the Hispanic culture as far as coming for that need to Habitat. Explain that a little bit.
Well, I think as more Hispanics have come to Southwest Florida, we have seen them at Habitat for Humanity. And at this point, I would say nearly a third of our homeowners are Hispanic, of some Hispanic descent now.
Great, great, great. Mm-hmm. Well, on that note, let's hold that note for a second, because we'll be right back. So sit tight, don't go anywhere. TV Community Awareness Show will be right back.
Hey.
You are watching the Community Awareness Show.
What will you build? A wall? A roof? A room? Or will you build a stronger family, healthier children, more successful students? What will you build? Every year, thousands of volunteers, donors, and partner families build houses and so much more with Habitat for Humanity. They build hope in your community and a brighter future around the world. So what will you build? Find out at Habitat.org and help build it.
As we spoke about the Hispanic community, there's a great need that you see for them because the Hispanic community is growing within our county. Mm-hmm. Can you elaborate a little bit more on that?
Yes. We have a number of bilingual employees at Habitat for Humanity, and our program is really a process. So we work with our family over a period of sometimes more than a year. So we spend a fair amount of time with, we have home ownership advisors, and they sit with families one-on-one and go through their budgets with them and make sure that they're ready for this step. And so they will help them understand their credit, the things that they need to do to clean up their credit, and really work with them over a period of time so that they're prepared to be a homeowner.
About 6 years ago when the market crashed, a lot of people still fear that it's going to happen and it's still not the right time to buy a home. What would you tell someone that has a question like that or concern?
Well, I tell you, the market crash, of course, dramatically affected everybody in Southwest Florida, and we, Habitat for Humanity, was not alone. It affected us in a lot of ways. The first way it affected us is that we had homeowners who lost their jobs overnight and panicked and took off in search of work. So we had foreclosures for the first time in our history. Which was very sad and upsetting to us. We got through that period of time, and the good news about Habitat is if we have a foreclosure, we rehab the home and we resell it to another needy family.
Great,
so
great.
At least, you know, another family benefits from it, but our goal is not to go there. We really try to work with families so that if they lose a job or have their hours cut back, instead of hiding or thinking that, you know, they're going to lose their house, we say, come in and talk to us. We'll help you. We'll work out a budget. We'll help you find another job. You know, don't shirk your responsibilities. Come in and we'll work in partnership with you.
I just love what you just said. That was where I was going next, was to ask, Habitat for Humanity is not just about building homes. You just mentioned that you have a resource where you tell people, you know, or help them to get a job. What other areas does Habitat for Humanity sees and helps the community?
Mm-hmm. We get to know our families pretty well, and you know, they make their mortgage payments every month once they finish the program, and so often we hear about the life events that they face, that all families face. Mm-hmm. And so we do our best to be a very good, we can't solve every problem, but we try to have good referral resources and to be able to make them feel comfortable enough to talk with us so that we can help them get the help that they need and keep their homes. So we work with them in a lot of respects in that way. Another way that we work with families that a lot of people don't know because it's relatively new is that not only do we provide new homes to families that they can buy, but if a family is in a home that they already own and they have some critical repairs that need to be done that they can't afford or don't know how to go about getting done, we also have a program that is structured similarly to Habitat's program, where it's a hand up, not a handout. But we can help people if they've got to replace their roof or their hot water heater goes out and they don't have a way to pay for that. We can help them, again, through a loan that would be paid back with no interest and sweat equity.
Okay.
We can help them help stay in their homes as well.
So is that added on to their mortgage?
In most cases, we have them sign a promissory note and pay it back over time based on their income. Sometimes they don't, if they have very little income, they only have to pay back a portion of the cost.
What I admire, what I just heard, that when the market crashed a few years ago, Habitat for Humanity did not go nowhere. It's still here.
We are still here. And in some ways, we really benefited from the market crash because suddenly we could afford to buy land in areas where we never could before. We also got land donated to us that we can build on in the future that people felt didn't have any value anymore, but it has value to us. We also got into the rehabbing business. It was less expensive for us to take existing homes that banks had foreclosed on and either acquire them, or some of them were donated to us, and rehab those homes and put families into those. So now we build new homes from scratch, and we take existing homes and rehab them to be like new.
Great, great. What areas does Habitat for Humanity cover?
Our affiliate covers all of Lee County and all of Hendry County. Okay. There are separate Habitat affiliates in Collier County and in Charlotte County. So we operate very similarly, but we run separately.
Okay, great, great. Well, I also want to know, when you go out, do you specifically go out to certain areas to see where the need for a home is, or do you wait for someone to come to you?
It's a little bit of both. Okay. It's kind of a mixture of, I talk with the home ownership counselors to say, where's the demand? Where are people saying they want to be? In combination with, where can we afford to build? You know, lots of people would like to live on Sanibel Island.
Right.
I can't afford to build on Sanibel Island.
Good, good. So I'm concerned, once again, on the language barrier. There are people that are seeing us right now, and again, they might be intimidated because, well, I'm just going to say in regards to my culture, well, I don't speak English. You know, so can they help me if I go to them? What would you say to that?
I would say we have many families where they don't all speak English. Typically, the kids will speak English and they'll sort of be a translator. Okay. We do offer information sessions and initial brochures in Spanish. But, for example, the mortgage documents are all going to be in English.
Right.
So
okay.
They need to have somebody they can rely on who is a responsible adult who can translate for them at some point. But in general, we can work with anybody, and if they have a desire and a willingness, we'll find a way to make it work.
How long has Habitat for Humanity been around?
Our affiliate has been around since 1982, and in that time, just in Lee and Hendry counties, we have put 1,347 families into their own
safe and decent homes.
Yes.
Good, good, good.
Yes.
Well, you say 1982. Did it actually start in 1982?
Habitat International, the bigger organization, started in 1976. So we're one of the older affiliates in the nation, but we started in 1976. And Habitat International serves all over in 70 countries around the world, as well as there are 1,500 affiliates just in the United States.
Well, that's great to know. One thing that I just got reminded as we were talking, a lot of people may hear that and say, well, then that means I have to be a Christian to get a home. Can you?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. We are unashamed at putting God's love into action.
Great, great.
But we want to love everybody. Everybody is our neighbor, and we don't ask, and we don't care what your particular belief is. In fact, we have a specific non-proselytizing policy.
Okay.
So
they don't have to walk in with a Bible.
They do not.
I need your help.
We'll give them one of those.
Yeah. that is good. But that is the message that is being sent out to people in need. That
love your neighbor.
Love your neighbor. And we care. We are concerned. We want to help. And we
want
to help our community. That's what this show is all about. Community awareness. We want to work in unity with organizations such as yours to let our neighbors know that we do care about you. We are concerned with what you're going through. Because here it is, we're all in the same boat of survival. Some are blessed more than others, some are less fortunate, but whatever the circumstance, if we get together, I truly believe that in unity there is strength. And if we get together, we can do more than less.
Absolutely.
So, and that's why I'm so glad that Habitat for Humanity has not gone anywhere. With everything that happened around, you're still here. You're still blessing the communities. You're still a part of the neighbor.
Okay. We have some wonderful donors and volunteers who enable us to exist, and their support has not wavered despite the craziness in the market and otherwise. So
great. Now, if someone wanted, hearing us today and seeing us today, if someone is touched and says, well, I would like to give to Habitat for Humanity, once again, who would they call? Can they go on the website and donate online?
They can. Yeah, absolutely. Our website, they can donate directly online, or if they want to talk to somebody and understand a little bit more, they can call us at our main number, and we'd love to talk to them more about it. Or they can come to our Habitat 101 session that we have every month, where we just kind of give a one-hour overview about how we operate, what we do, And we have people there, and they can talk to us in more detail about how they might like to get involved.
Well, when you say every month, is it a specific day and time?
I'm glad you asked that. It's the third Tuesday of every month at noon, and we'll even give you a free lunch.
Oh, okay, great, great.
You are watching the Community Awareness Show.
SMP Productions y Kingdom Coalition Ministerial Alliance orgullosamente presenta por primera vez en Lehigh Acres, Florida, una noche de concierto con el Trío de Hoy. Trío de Hoy. Noviembre 6 del 2015 a las 6 de la noche en la Iglesia de Cristo Sendero de Esperanza, que radica en el 507 Sunshine Boulevard, Lehigh Acres, Florida. Para más información y boletos, pueden llamar al Pastor Pete Marrero al 239-240-0483, 239-240-0483, o a Andrés Santos al 239-257-0493, 239-257-0493. No se pierda una noche de concierto con el Trío de Hoy en vivo. Les esperamos. Auspiciado por Kingdom Coalition Ministerial Alliance Incorporated, New Dimension Network Immigration Services, Sonia Rios Realty, SMP Productions, Sendero de Esperanza, y Crystal Film Production.
Welcome back to the TV Community Awareness Show. Miss Kitty, I wanted to ask you, where does Habitat for Humanity receive its funding from?
Well, we receive our funding from really a lot of sources. First off, our homeowners make mortgage payments.
Okay.
So it's almost like a perpetual fund, you know. Okay. Somebody makes a payment so somebody else can own a new home. So that's one source. We also get donations from individuals, from churches, from grant sources that we write grants for. We also recently we're getting more and more of our funding from our restores. And our restores are, that's the name of the Habitat for Humanity. It's kind of a thrift store. And okay. We resell donated items, both new and used. And it's furniture, building materials, housewares. Our North Fort Myers restore even has clothing and books. So just about anything you're looking for, you can find in one of our stores. And the starting pricing in our stores is at 50% of retail, and it goes down from there. So you can find some great deals in our stores.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
I want to know, is Habitat for Humanity just for families? Just say if you have a couple comes in, and they want to have their own home. You know, everyone that lives here always says the American dream is to have their own home.
Absolutely.
Do they have to have children in order to qualify for Habitat for Humanity? Do you build a two-bedroom home, a three-bedroom home, a four-bedroom home? How does that work?
Well, sort of two different questions. So the first question is, we have no specific rules around how many kids you have to get a Habitat for Humanity home. But we only have the resources to provide so many homes. And we have a volunteer selection committee who has to make the ultimate decision on who gets the homes that we have available to us. And that committee looks at, again, those selection criteria, need, ability to pay, and willingness to partner. Probably, if we only had one home available, and we had two families that were identical, except one family had two kids and the other family had no kids, my guess is that they would probably decide that the greater need was with the larger family. But that's not a hard and fast rule. And sometimes we get houses, when we build homes, they are usually 3 and 4 bedroom homes. But we get homes donated to us from banks, we buy homes, and sometimes they're small, sometimes they're large. When we have a smaller home, then it's appropriate for a couple without kids. So there's no real rules. I think if it's a couple that doesn't have kids and they have an interest, come talk to us. And we'll be as honest as we can be about what we have available and what your chances are of getting in. I have to tell you, though, there is a lot of people out there with a need.
Yes.
Last year, for the information sessions that we have that are the initial point of information, we had 1,200 families, not individuals, but families, come to one of those sessions. And this year we'll be able to put 55 families in homes.
That is great.
So it's a lot of homes that we're providing, and a lot for a Habitat affiliate. But the need is tremendous in this area. So we're always striving to find more resources so that we can put more of those families into homes.
I want to say to our viewers that are watching us, especially those that have businesses, and even big businesses like Lowe's or Home Depot, once again, I want you to emphasize on your website and your phone number so that they can call. And if you have any last minute words to our viewers, please let them know what the need also is for Habitat for Humanity.
Okay. So the website address is www.habitatforhumanity.org, and the four is the number, not the word. And the phone number is area code 239-652-0434. And through either of those sources, you can get the answer to pretty much any question that you might have. And, you know, I would invite any of your listeners to partner with us. That's one of the things that's so neat about Habitat is that there are so many ways to be involved with us. You know, there are certainly families who have a need for housing, and we love to see them come in and try to help them. But there are other people who have extra time on their hands. Boy, we can use the volunteers. Last year we had 6,000 volunteers, and it still wasn't enough.
Wow.
We always need more volunteers. And it doesn't just have to be in the construction realm. We love construction volunteers, but we understand that there are people who that's not what they want to do.
Right.
So we have three restores. We need people to help us sort and price furniture, repair furniture, move furniture. We have four trucks where we pick up and deliver furniture, so we need truck drivers and helpers and that sort. We always have things in the office that need doing. So we can, if somebody has some spare time, it doesn't matter what their skills are, we can put them to work.
Great. So in other words, you don't have to be a skilled worker?
Absolutely not. People really think that they, you know, they assume they have to have skills to work on a construction site. We have staff that are construction employees, and they're very knowledgeable, and their whole job is to guide untrained volunteers and show them how to do what we ask them to do for that particular day. So it's really a great place to learn some skills.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
But you need people to clean up, the people to...
Absolutely.
That is great.
Absolutely.
Well, before we leave, Ms. Kitty, once again, I want to thank you for being here, being on our show, letting our viewers know what Habitat for Humanity wants to do. Now, what Habitat for Humanity wants to do for themselves, but what they want to do for community. Because that's what we're all about here. We want to reach out to our neighbors and let them know, once again, there are still good people here in this world. There are people with a heart, and that we are here to serve. That is our ministry. That is our passion. And before we leave, Ms. Kitty, once again, would you mind just giving that website and phone number again?
Okay. Area code 239-652-0434, and the website is www.habitatforhumanity.org.
Great. Well, Ms. Kitty, I want to thank you for being here, and once again, this is the beginning of a wonderful connection between Community TV Awareness Show, Habitat for Humanity, and also the Kingdom Coalition of Ministers, Businessmen, and Women. We want to work together for the better good. Thank you once again, and we want to thank our viewers for watching TV Community Awareness Show.
SMP Productions y Kingdom Coalition Ministerial Alliance orgullosamente presenta por primera vez en Lehigh Acres, Florida, una noche de concierto con el Trío de Hoy. Trío de Hoy. Noviembre 6 del 2015 a las 6 de la noche en la Iglesia de Cristo Sendero de Esperanza, que radica en el 507 Sunshine Boulevard, Lehigh Acres, Florida. Para más información y boletos.